द टेंथ प्रॉब्लम ऑफ आवर पैराबोला चैप्टर इज अ वेरी नाइस प्रॉब्लम. इट अपीयर्स टू बी अ लॉन्ग प्रॉब्लम बट आई वुड सजेस्ट यू नेवर जज एनी प्रॉब्लम बाय इट्स लेंथ बिकॉज इवन द मोस्ट लेंथी प्रॉब्लम समटाइम्स बिकम्स वेरी ईजी इफ यू अप्लाई द जनरल बेसिक कंसेप्ट ऑफ पैराबोला. O is the vertex of parabola y square is equal to 4ax such that the normals at P, Q and R pass through S. The normals cut the axis of X at A, B and C such that OA, OB and OC are in AP. We need to find the locus of point S. I would suggest you to attempt these kind of lengthy problems or tricky problems in such a way that you go step by step and try to cover each and every data which has been given in the problem. First of all, it is given that three normals have been made at point P, Q and R. Now we know that slope of normal is equal to minus t where at square comma 280 is the point at which the normal has been made. We can prove this since 1 by t is the slope of tangent, hence the negative reciprocal will be the slope of normal. Hence, we can write this point as am square comma minus 2am, where m is any general slope of the normal. Now, let us write the equation of normal. Y plus 2am is equal to slope, which is m into x minus am square. If we assume the slope, any general slope, to be equal to m, then the point will be am square comma minus 2am, and hence the equation of normal will be this, which is am cube plus 2a minus x times m plus y equals 0. Now we have utilized the first information that three normals are drawn at points P, Q and R. Now we need to find the locus of point S at which these three normals intersect. If we consider the point to be H, K, then this H, K will satisfy this normal or this cubic equation. This becomes AM cube plus 2A minus H times M plus K is equal to 0. Now we can see the three normals are having the slopes m1, m2 and n3 are the three roots of this cubic equation in M. So m1 plus m2 plus m3 can be written equal to 0 since there is no coefficient of m square. This is our first equation. Then sigma m1, m2 can be written equal to 2a minus h upon a. This is our second relation, and product of roots taken all at a time is m1, m2, m3 is equal to minus k upon a. This is our third equation. Now, general equation of the normal was am cube plus 2a minus x times m plus y equals 0. Now we go on to the second information. The information is that these three normals cut the axis of x at A, B and C. The axis of x represents y equals 0. Hence we put y equals 0 in this equation to get am cube plus 2a minus x times m equals 0, which gives us x is equal to 2a plus m square. Hence, the three points will be a, b and c, that is 2a plus m1 square, 2a plus m2 square and 2a plus m3 square. Now, we go on to the next information, which is OA, OB and OC are in AP, and the lengths OA, OB and OC, since the a, b and c are lying on the x axis, these are the lengths of the x coordinate of the points A, B and C. Hence, 2A plus M1 square, 2A plus M2 square and 2A plus M3 square are in AP. Hence, we can see 2 times 2A plus M2 square is equal to 2A plus M1 square plus 2A plus M3 square. This 4A and 4A gets cancelled and we get 2M2 square is equal to M1 square plus M3 square. Now, what we can do is we add M2 square both sides to get 3M2 square and we can write this thing as M1 plus M2 plus M3 whole square minus 2 sigma M1 M2. We know that M1 plus M2 plus M3 is 0, hence this becomes equal to 0. So, this becomes 3M2 square is equal to minus 2 times sigma M1 M2, which is equal to 2A minus H upon A. Hence, we have got value of M2 square as minus 2 upon 3A times 2A minus H. This is our fourth equation. Also, we have 2m2 square is equal to m1 square plus m3 square. This we can again write it as m1 plus m3 whole square minus 2m1 m3. Previously, what we did was we added m2 square both the sides in order to make this m1 square plus m2 square plus m3 square. And now what we are doing is we are converting this into m1 plus m3 whole square minus 2m1 m3. And we know that m1 plus m3 is equal to minus m2. So, this we can write as minus m2 square, which is m2 square. And from over here, we know that m1 m3 is equal to minus k upon a m2. So, this becomes plus 2 k upon a m2. This is equal to 2 m2 square. Hence, the value of m2 square, or rather this is 2am2 and not square. So, value of m2 square comes out to be equal to 2k upon am2, or m2 cube comes out to be equal to 2k by a. This is our fifth equation. Now, from the fourth and the fifth equation, we can equate the value of m2, or rather what we can do is, here we can square and here we can cube to get m2 power 6 and m2 power 6 both sides. So, on squaring this, we get 4k square upon a square and equating this with m2 power 6 over here to get minus 8 upon 27a cube into 2a minus h whole cube. This gets cancelled. This a square and a cube gets cancelled and we get 27ak square is equal to 2 times h minus 2a whole cube, or replacing h comma k by x comma y, we get 27 ay square is equal to 2 times x minus 2a whole cube. Hence, what we saw in this problem was, although it was a bit of lengthy problem, but it was not so much difficult as it appeared in the beginning. What we did is, we just went step by step, used each and every information that was given in the problem and got the final result for the locus of point S, where the three normals were intersecting as 27ay square is equal to 2 times x minus 2a whole cube, which is our final answer.